the part are actually pretty much same, like other Windows, sir. You have to put quantity and other things. Once you raise this request, sir, then there will be this copy to option will be available, sir. Okay. Once this this stock get available, then the issuer or like the approver, they will have a notification or they can use this stock transfer window. So either they can copy from your request, or they can simply go to this stock transfer window and make a copy to and make the approval there. So this is something a stock transfer case, sir. It might. Yes, sir. It is from warehouse to warehouse. So as per your requirement, it might be seem irrelevant right now, but I'll be lining it up, sir. Like after. Right, sir. Yes, sir. Right, sir. Yes, sir, right, you. Right, and sir, see, in the warehouse master, there is a concept of dropship warehouse, which is practically a logical warehouse, sir. I mean, wherever the item is getting, it will be a dropship. Yes, sir, this is a warehouse creation window, sir. I mean, this is something a master setup, sir. When you are. Okay. Fine, sir. Then what kind of code I should use? Let me check, sir. So this is like warehouse 11, 12. Yes, sir. I'll be creating a new one. So I'll be using WS13. Then I am using this WS13. And what will be the name, sir? BHL. Okay. And the location here will be Rampal, the site. Okay. And there won't be anything. So these are actually minimum requirement for the location and other part. Then the next part here, sir, this code has to be defined from the finance team, sir, actually. Like what will be the expense account, stock account. So right now what I'll be doing, I'll be just copying one, this furnace tank warehouse as a like dummy warehouse for BHL, okay. In this case, I'll be then just duplicate, putting this name as 13 and BHL. Example, and see this automatically it will be fetched from the previous warehouse. Okay, and now I'm sir, I actually did it from the last warehouse which was already created, for example warehouse 12 or warehouse 11. Yes, sir. Okay, so this is actually the process which I'm doing, but before doing it, sir, some workout is required, you know, just to verify these accounts from the Yes, sir. Those things need to be done, sir. So you just duplicate it here, and I'm doing it again. BHEL, and it will be the Rampal warehouse and the accounting part. So after this, I'm marking it as add. So my new warehouse is now get created. So it's taking some time. Okay, it's done. Now, if I go to any stock management item also, you can see in my stock data, this 13 is available here. Okay. So this is the process, and sir, the task you are asking, this is more like similar to our police project, sir. I mean, in police, what's happening, sir? The central headquarter, police headquarter, they procure all the item for the whole of Bangladesh police unit, and they issue those items, and at the end of the month they actually get the report like which people has received those items and all sort of things, sir. So for that requirement we actually developed some part based on this good issue and good receive, sir. Okay, so here you can check in the good issue. Well, this is the window. You can see, sir, as of now there has been no entry in the good issue. It's showing like one still. Okay. So now this window, what actually happened here, you can directly reduce some item from your stock, sir. I mean, it will get issued. to a particular person or whoever it is. In, okay, sir. So in this good issue window, you have to come and like you have to select all the item. Yes, sir. See in this right, there is no stock here, sir. You can see. And let me check whether there is any item with the stock or not. I believe that there. Understood. Exactly, sir. Yes, but sir, see, in your current practice, we did not entertain this good receipt because this window it allow user to directly update the. Yes, sir. Without GRPO, sir. But in your. Exactly, sir. Yes, without GRPO. But in your. Okay, sir. I'm checking. Yes, sir. Exactly. Because I think there's three is actually something fixed as an item. This one, sir, good service. So this is actually this is not a stock item, sir. You can see it is unchecked. When we are creating an item master, sir, you can see. Yes, sir. See, for example, OEM steel. These are actually marked as a stock item. Okay, but when you are going to these three series, the all of these are actually not. These are not stock items, sir. See, these are. Yeah. Exactly, sir. Yes. Yeah, I'm here, sir. You please continue. Okay. Okay. Sir, in that there is a small complexity will be there because see the finance team they are maintaining a separate item code, and you'll be maintaining a separate item code. So in this case, yes, sir, there might be a duplicacy or like you know there might be a error prone entry, sir. For example, in exactly, sir. Because whatever item you want to actually put in the stock, you have to receive this through that particular item, sir. That is actually, sir, recommended. Otherwise, sir, you can see here. Let me show you. See, for example, this LAN cable. So this is something a stock item, sir. I believe you have no. Let me check whether stock. Oh no, that is actually not it. This is not recommended, sir, because you are not. I mean, what should I say? Inventorize that item, sir. That item has no existence in there. So this is why, it's actually, sir, this problem happening online. Yes, sir. Exactly, sir. Exactly. Yes. And you can see, sir, I mean, as per your business requirement, we had to create those items in the stock master because let me show you, sir, in the purchase. Okay. Yes, sir. In the purchase request, you have to, and even, sir, see, here is the option like item type and service type. But as per your requirement, we could not map it with this offering, sir. Because of that, we had to create that nine three items, sir. That I mean, the item with the three series, sir. Here, this three and good and service. Otherwise, sir, the standard practice should be like this. Let me just show you. I mean, though it is not relevant, you have to go to the service item, then you have to define some description here, which does not have any master, but a description part. But in your business practice, sir, you have to create a master for your service item. That is why. Yes, sir. Understood. Okay, but sir, yeah, understood. But sir, that practice has to be, you know, sir, stop. If you want to make a... Sure. Sure, sir, let me then... Yes, sir, let me show you one live demo, sir, here. I am going to good receive directly, and I am selecting this. You can even check, sir, when I click this button, sir, the default item list is not showing any three item list, sir. You can see that. Yes, sir. So now what I'll be doing, I'll be selecting LAN cable, one keyboard and mouse, these three items, and I'm putting some stock here, sir. So my LAN cable, what is the UM here? Meter. So it will be like 20 meters. Keyboard will be 5 pieces and mouse will be 5 pieces. And in the time of good receipts, sir, you actually have to put a price. I don't think so, sir. That is something I believe a central setup. I need to check that part a little bit, sir. Okay. Okay. Let's assume there is no item. I'm trying to put it in a zero value. Let's see what happens. Dummy entry for testing. And you can see this account code. It will be automatically, sir, tagged here. It is a material issue for raw material. Okay, this item code need to be changed, sir. I mean, in the future practice, it has to be also checked, sir. Sir, I mean this account code, sir. This account, it might need change, sir. Maybe because now all these items are under repair and maintenance, sir. Okay, but when you will be actually inventorizing this item, then I believe there might be some change required. Because those items will not be under repair and maintenance. It might be some other section, sir. Maybe IT or something like that. Okay, sir. And if I'm not wrong, sir, that this good receive code, it has to be in the asset part here, sir. Not in the expenditure. So currently it is under expenditure. But I think it has to be changed in the asset part. I mean, later on, sir. Yes, sir. No, actually, sir, that asset is something which is in the chart of account part, sir, not in asset code, sir. Okay, no issue, sir. Then I am going to add this item here. Okay, yes. Document rollover cost center is missing. Okay, I think here. Let's put it as head office general, sir. Okay, just for testing. Oh, project code is also required. Understood, sir. Okay. Oh, okay. You didn't save it, sir. I mean, so the stock. Okay, sir, currently the zero value is there. I mean, the acceptance is there from the central setup. You can actually activate it or inactivate it also. Like without price, it will not receive an item. It got added, sir. Now you can check also in the stop posting list if you go to the report here. Well, this is the okay, sir. I think that was related to this account code here. I mean, in the chart of accounts, sir, some setup are required in this part here. In this account detail issue, this kind of thing activation or like those things might be required, sir. Or if you can regenerate that error, sir, you just provide me the snapshot, then I will recheck, sir. No issue. No, it came by default, sir. I mean, this database is actually an older one, sir. I mean. Oh, okay, sir. Actually, what happened? We created this backup right after closing that posting period, sir. I mean, yes, sir. You can check. I mean, when Rajesh sir closed this, yes, sir. That you can, sir. Yes. I mean, once Rajesh sir confirmed it, then actually we took a backup and restored it. Then he did some when checking. Then actually we restored it here. That might have happened, sir. I mean, I'm not 100% sure why that happened, but that might be a possibility, sir. Okay, so now, yes, and you can actually check the stock list here. I mean, how it actually happened. Okay, so now what I'll be doing, I'm going to this item master to show you how it actually happened. So now you go to the land cable stock data, you can see here, sir, the general stock is 200. It is here, sir. Okay, and you can see, sir, this land. This port here, it got grayed out because now this item got locked. Whenever there is some quantity, you cannot delete or change any item, sir. Okay, not even the unit of measurement. Okay, sir. So, sure, that is already here, sir. Let me just show you. In the stock management or in the inventory, you go to stock report or inventory report. There is this stock posting list, sir. So this is basically a very exhaustive report, and I am going to the stock posting list, hide item without zero quantity. I'm selecting all the items, sir. Okay, from all the location and everything, and this is my date. I am clicking okay. So this is the dip. Okay, no data available. Okay, let me see. Selection criteria. Okay, so sir, you can see this is the posting date. I mean, as of today's date, this is actually the number of your item. 231 is a number code. This is the document row. I mean, in this document number SI, which representing stock in item, this is the second row item. This is the third row item. This is the first row item. All these items has been stored in this warehouse, and this is the received quantity, sir. Here, five pieces, and 200 meters. Okay, as you haven't put any price, that's why the price is zero, and this is your current balance. Okay. Yeah, of course, sir. You can just like copy table from here, or you can put, I mean, Excel from this here also. I'm the copy table, and now I'm going to an Excel. Okay. Okay. Yes, sir, exactly. Okay, fine, sir. So, see this application process, sir. In the system, there is currently no application mechanism, sir, by default. Okay. But what you can do, sir, if you are maintaining any issue book or maybe Indian book, sir, that you can actually map with this book issue. For example, sir, I mean, you have an Indian number, maybe an Indian book, and me, Rizvi, I'm coming to you. Okay, Vidu, sir, you please give me 50 meter of LAN cable and two mouse and one keyboard. Okay, and I have a reference number, and you are putting the reference number here, my book number. Okay, so maybe this book you are publishing, it will be like 2008001. I think it's okay. So this. Okay, sir, actually that request part we did not map because as they are a government entity, sir, they are maintaining this Indian book mechanism, sir. I mean that physical document. And they are putting everything in there, sir. I will show you that development also, sir. I mean, if you want that much control, sir, that can be easily developed, but we need to do some work in that part, sir. That much only. Okay. So that is manual, sir. Complete manual process. Because I mean, what they are doing, print this manual book from their government press, sir, in Tehsil. Okay, so that book has a continuous serial number and every kind of things. So they follow those, I mean, directly. For example, sir, in the head office or in every unit, they have a particular designation, say additional SP, SP, or even, sir, this additional DIG. Against all the designation, they have a particular book. And that serial number is as per that designation and that sorting, sir, actually. So because of that. Yes, sir, that you can. And one thing is that, sir, I mean, if the ESS was there, I mean, the spine part, sir, then it could have been done through the request test. So in your online processor, you can actually adapt that idea also. Like whatever. Actually, we also did some development in the police part. I'll be showing you, sir, because for the reporting purpose, sir. So let me just show you one thing here, sir, like so that I can actually go to that police part also. Okay, sir, you can see this is the stock which is visible now to the issuer. I mean, if you are issuing, then I have requested maybe 50 quantity. If I would have requested, for example, 230, it would not actually. Okay, so you have the control, like how much you want to provide, sir. Maybe I so what we did in the police, sir, we provided on requested quantity column here. That's additional column, sir, so they can actually put the requested quantity. And now this is here, this part is done. Okay, and this is the issuer receive type capex conversion. I think this is something a UDF which we created, sir. Okay, and conversion item code is not required. I think the distribution rule, so this can also be automated, but for your business requirement, it is like it will be selected every time. Sorry. Okay, so this let me hide these three column at the bottom. This is not required. This is not required. This is not required. Okay, let it be. Fine. Now you can put, I mean, issued to RISD. Just for example, and as we mentioned, so like this could be the 3700189. Maybe your employee code, sir, as you mentioned. Okay. This is the posting date, and now I mean, even sir, that if you have a digital printout, sir, maybe a PDF or something, as you mentioned, you can just put it in the attachment also. Achha. Like if I go to this browser and okay, so you can just select a code here, and it will be updated, sir. Okay. But I better delete it, sir, because it's a does guard us by
don't
some.
think this hard copy will move forward. It is not required. Unnecessary, it will increase my space.
Item cost to go. Sir, here you can see without the cost, it is not actually receiving, issuing any item, sir. Okay. The problem is here that you have to put the otherwise my stock value won't be actually, sir, actual. Okay, understood, sir. Just 1 minute. Oh, sir, the thing problem is not happening due to this account code actually, sir. Not for the pricing. Let me show you, sir. When you are making an issue, sir, okay. In this part, this warehouse need this depending here, sir. This purchase credit account, this sales credit account. These two account need to be provided, sir, for that item level also. And after that, this will happen. So, sir, rather than going forward here, I am just going to the police database, sir, so that I can just show you this process, sir. Okay. So this is actually the practice. Once you've done it, then it will show you that.
I have done this thing. You see, it was working from my. I created one item, na, then I was able to issue this thing.
Okay, sir, which database you used actually, so that I can check from
VFPSL
that.
practice. VFPSL practice.
Okay, fine.
So it was working that time. So that thing was working. Then I wanted one report where I can see if to whom I have issued that thing.
Okay, sir, that report is not actually built in here. We have to develop that part, sir. Let me just show you a dummy for the police part, like the how the development might happen, sir, which I can give you an idea here only.
Also, na, like this VIPC
Oh, sir,
plus
that one. That is actually, sir, not recommended, but I will try to do that, sir. No issue. I mean, it was actually the police, and they were, sir, actually so much, strict.
that is one JPG image only. What is the big thing actually? It should
No,
be
no.
SAP should come at corner somewhere, powered by SAP, something like that. Why they put unnecessary this ladies image, you know? Doesn't
I
require
understood.
anything. It is everywhere in SAP all system.
Exactly, sir. But I don't know what is the, I mean, specialty of these things are actually in the SAP part.
It doesn't do any performance issue or something like that.
Maybe actually, sir,
They
what
should
happened?
even they should
So,
recommend this thinking is company logo should be coming here. I don't know why SAP is like this.
sir, even for to change this logo, sir, we called the SAP support team directly, sir. Like it is a particular requirement to do it. And after that, sir, I mean, so upside down we did it. Anyway, sir, I will try that, sir. No problem. You just give me an email. I will give you the the dimension so that we can change it, sir. Okay. So, sir, let me show you in the police part, sir. You can see that I mean the development we did could issue. Sorry. Okay, sir, in the police practice, they actually follow this way. So this is a indent number, like the book, as you mentioned. That re reference has been renamed as per this book number part, which is that they have an indent number. And you can see they actually mentioning these parts, sir, the receiver police ID, receiver name, their designation, okay, the mobile number, those sort of things were actually mentioned there. Okay, and for which section they are actually taking, because they have I mean, practice of the section wise I mean distribution, sir. Okay.
Actually, this much detail we don't want, what is mobile number or some designation, all this, only employee number is.
Sure, sir. I mean, for your practice, sir, only the reference number field can be used, sir. I mean, that will be more than okay. And even, sir, in the I mean in the reporting area, let me show you can use
Actually,
that
reporting
reference
area
number.
should be coming. This item is with this person actually, so that I can track the item basically.
Understood, sir. Actually, in the police, we did some customized reports, sir. For example, if I go to this itemized issue summary, this is just one report. I am selecting from August 1 till today. and this warehouse here, the police headquarters is stored and for all the items. Oh, sorry, I think this is 5. Okay, so sir. Okay, but sir, it actually has to be developed, sir. This is something, I mean, which is not there, but we can do it. So this is like this aerosol, this one item. This one item actually issued on 3rd May, 2 quantity, on 4th May, 4 quantities, sir, this way. And who actually received this quantity? Faisal, Hashem, these are the names, sir. And even if I mean, in the built-in screen, sir, what you can do, inventory posting list. Okay, sir. See, this is the same report, sir, which I showed you earlier, that the posting list report. I am selecting all item from a particular date range. Let 010620. And if you go to expand, then you can actually select that reference. Sir. This is the reference to the field used in the built-in screen, sir. You can just select. Yes, sir. This is the indent number, or for your case, sir, it could be that employee code, sir. Okay, like whatever mapping we will be doing, that you can select this reference to code from here. So this is something, a built-in report you can get. And if I go to this stock report, like let me show you like how this report actually works, sir, which I could not show you earlier. Okay, sir, you can see this key box. This is the opening balance, like which was stored in 1719. This is the, in this one quantity issued, sir. After the opening item, the balance was -1. And initially we allowed the negative balance. After that, sir, what happened? This Muhammad Kamal, he actually received this 60 quantity and it became 60 here. Okay, so this is how you, this report actually show you the latest status by daily, monthly, even yearly, sir. So at 20. Yes, sir. This is an inbuilt report, sir, which I showed you.
Can come from this setting also, no? Because reference 2 was not coming, then I went to setting, then it was showing employee number also.
Exactly, sir. Yes.
Right now in column it is not coming, reference 2.
You can, sir. Actually, you can just easy. Yes, sir. This reference 2, sir, here. You can just select it and that much only, sir. And answer actually giving you a training how we have done this, sir, and how we have done this before, sir. Actually, okay. So in this, you can actually comply by yourself also, sir, no issue, in the report area or like this UDF area also. And there are
additional thing is that this report, basically this summary it is showing, this report is good, that for that we can go for, and all other things are coming. Only thing is that online request is not available. I mean, somebody cannot request this toner or that toner. It has to be done parallelly.
But sir, actually, I mean, we also proposed that online request here by the development phase. But as you know, the police do not have the practice of online requirement. Only because of that, we could not provide it, sir.
No,
I mean, for you, we...
It's possible to do this online request. How it will be?
Sir, in that case, we have to create a separate form, sir, here.
Because my requirement is very, very minimal, actually. What I will do, I will create a common user ID only for this thing. So my form will, what my form will contain, my this employee number, who is requesting. Suppose I am requesting a toner, so I will enter my employee number and then I will choose the item code. And I will enter the quantity, how much quantity I want. That's it, the C4 information I want.
Understood.
For this thing.
Sir, if I want to comply with your requirement within this ACP, I mean, in that case, that common ID concept might not be possible, sir. Why? Because if I am creating any, sir, for example, you can see here in the police project, sir, we developed some custom defined form here, sir, which is integrated with that document E also, sir, that policy. Okay. So this is like actually as per the requirement. So we can develop this additional form, even sir, additional cycle. But it has to be within that user, sir. For example, you are using this ACC01 user.
That's why I am saying, listen, suppose I have 300 employees, because 300 or 1,000. So, for only doing this job, why I should purchase 1,000 of licenses of SAP? Through single. Suppose I am not telling my 1,000 employees to create this thing. What I will do, I will put a person. person who will, what he will do, he will do the job of requesting actually on behalf of them.
And
then what he will do the login, and he will, because he is the just medium actually, so many persons are coming, so in the form there will be one this item means reference to or something field will be there, so where
that can
enter the concerned person employee number, that's it.
So that can be easily done. I mean, then only one license is required. I mean, by license, I mean the login access for only one person.
I am not that going to distribute to everybody. Because
I don't.
One store person will be there whose job is to issue. Only he will issuing the item. And one store person will be there who will request on behalf of my 1,000 employee or 2,000 employee or 10,000 employee. His job is to request actually.
Sir,
in this
I think
my recording will be proper. I can track him as which employee is having what item.
Understood. So, sir, I mean, this request mechanism, is it like open for all? Maybe I am your employee, you are my reporting boss, and I need something on my desk. So, shall I inform you first, or like I can directly request it? I mean, how the process is?
That's why we want to make it simple.
Fine.
Offline, he can discuss with my boss ki I should give this PC to him or not. That is his decision making. We don't want to put it paperwork or unnecessary. These are unnecessary things. It is going to boss or something like that. No?
Sir, actually, in my previous organization where I used to work, that was a garments factory, sir. So there was one practice they made like this. Suppose there are 7 departments, sir. Okay. And there are 7 departmental head. What the store guy did, he issued all relevant quantities to the departmental head. For example, sir, the HR department, they have 7 computers. Okay. So the issuer, the store team, what they did, they distributed 7 mouse, like what are the main reason, and they distributed 3 spare mouse to the departmental head at the very beginning of the month or something. So whenever there will be a requirement of something, the departmental head will be liable to distribute those items to their employee. Maybe there are requisition of.
Because when the single user person will request, that form should be available. Like you are giving a print of PR, purchase request and purchase order. In similar manner, if that form can be printed, so there we can give a signature field also. HOD can sign or something like that, then it will go for issuing actually.
Yes, sir. That can be done, sir.
My license issue will be resolved, and I can also track each and every item as per my employee number actually.
Sir, actually, there can be a workaround without any development, sir, which I can show you now. Let's see. Using this transfer request now, this can be done, sir. I mean, why am... I mean that much I'm saying, sir. I mean, without thinking as a warehouse, you can raise this request to your internal team also, sir. So that internal store team could be a requisitor, sir. So what in that case, sir, what can be done? I mean, whoever is,
I want to request a mouse or keyboard, how I will request a mouse and how it will be recorded. I have requested that thing.
Okay, so sir, for that you have to define all your section as a warehouse here, sir. That could be something, I mean, a little bit redundant, but it will provide you a better control in the system. Why, sir? Because whenever there is something development, there is a chance of, you know, sir, some bug or anything. As sir, I mean, so in this form warehouse, suppose I am working in the IT department. So my from warehouse, it will be like something, my IT where, IT,
no,
IT section.
No, two warehouse. Now, one is that GRPU warehouse, when my item is purchased. On that day, I will keep it in GRPU warehouse and I can make another warehouse, issuing warehouse. So what I will do, using this inventory transfer request, I will pick item from my GRPU warehouse to issuing warehouse.
Issuer.
Is it possible?
So that can be possible. I mean, that could be definitely possible, but I just need to check that, you know, feasibility in a sense, like how many requests are raising in a single day, how much we can actually map this thing. I mean, it could be.
Suppose there are 20,000 items in my GRP warehouse. I have purchased 20,000 items. That is available,
yes,
in GRP warehouse, and it will not be issued from there. It will be my internal route. From GRP
Yes, exactly, sir. That is what I am saying, sir. I mean, in the good, we did this practice in the standard financial project, sir. In that project, sir, I mean, they wanted to map their quality mechanism within the built-in process, sir. Okay. So what we did, they actually had two different warehouse. One is the quality warehouse, like whenever the product is receiving in their factory end or even their head office end, it is getting by default the quality. Once the quality inspection is done, then the quality engineer making a request, like from quality warehouse to, sir, an issue warehouse. And they are putting a remarks and everything in that there. And this is how they are actually mapping the quality mechanism there. So that can also be done, sir. But that is nothing like option A and option B, sir. So once you...
But after doing this exercise, my request will be recorded in the report. Na? As a user, I requested toner. So what practically I am doing, I am asking my store person to remove two number of toner from GRPO warehouse to issuing warehouse. So that thing is recorded in system under my name. I have given that request.
Yes, sir, right.
And based on this request, my store person will transfer that item from GRPO warehouse to issuing warehouse. That thing is also recorded.
Yes, and after that, they will actually issue the...
Actual good issue transaction can be done by my store person. So all these three steps has been done and all three recording is there for particular toner stock item. I can see from which warehouse it has moved to which warehouse and who has requested and to whom it has been issued. All this record I wanted in the report and it is available. So my purpose is solved in that case.
Exactly, sir. Yes. But sir, one thing I can, I mean, suggest you in this case as a phase two expansion, sir. Suppose currently the development part you are asking, you can also consider barcoding for the future purpose, sir, also, which is not right now here. And you can also implement bin code mechanism. I mean, rag bin mechanism, sir. Okay. In that case, what will happen, sir? I mean, there is an option which is currently not usable here. I'm going to your data.
My requirement is now coming completely online. Now I don't need any offline system like in police headquarters you are having this indent book, something like that.
Yes, sir. That is because, sir, they are practice, sir. I mean, we did not have any other option. That is why, sir.
My complete transaction is coming online as SAP, without any additional license or something like that.
Yeah, I believe so, sir. Yes. I mean, that can be actually done. Yes, sir. That would be only some inbuilt object or like field has to be developed, sir, because just to put those additional information, sir. For example, that your name or some other things, sir. So that can be easily done, sir. No issue. I mean, that much we can work on, sir. Sorry. $8.
Actually, this thing I am clarity stock management part. Only thing, this financial impact I am not knowing. Why these finance people are having this 309 code and why they are not creating this 2 series code, something like that.
Oh, actually, sir, I mean, during the
impact, I am not knowing. Suppose warehouse to warehouse transfer, which I told, GRPO warehouse to.
Right, sir.
So, what accounting impact it will have or no impact it will have? So, that clarity I am not having.
Sir, actually, see, all these services, I mean, in my item master, the system is getting this as a single item, okay? But in the description, you're actually providing the item details, servicing, troubleshooting, cash, these sort of things, sir. So this is okay. See, in this inverse RS technology, you can see, sir, servicing, charge, troubleshooting, compressor, repairing, fitting, all of these are service type equipment, sir. This is acceptable, which I believe. But as you mentioned that, mouse, keyboard, those sort of things that definitely has to be, you know, the...
That is the item code part. Suppose I will create item code, but if I do warehouse to warehouse transfer, I don't think it should have any accounting implication. This is what I'm asking. This request, inventory transfer request if I do.
No, sir, that will be having something like account report will be same. That will show you like the warehouse stock report in a different manner. Okay, but sir, you can see here, there's ETP equipment. Okay, now you have a laptop as per technical specification, Lenovo original USB wired mouse and Transcend 32 GB. Now, you can see, sir, you cannot issue these three items because standard 32 GB, this is like an EDPA equipment, which is a service item, not a, it's non-stock item, sir. Okay, so if you want to issue this transient 32 GB USB, this item has to have a different code. This Lenovo Origin USB has to have a different code, sir. Only then you can actually issue those things because, you know, sir, when you are going to maintain this stock mechanism, there will be warranty issues, there will be these barcode issues, there will be these bin card issues, sir. I mean, the rag bin issues. So, I mean, that future provision has to be made now. I mean, when you are actually going to implicate this stock mechanism part, sir.
How the
Otherwise,
bar barcode will be utilized, I'm not getting. Means when I'm creating item, that time I have to use this barcode or what? How it will be?
Sir, see, in SAP, the barcode generation is not there, sir. I mean, the code part will not be generated, but that can be done with a separate API. And once the barcode is generated, you can actually store it in the item master here. Here, sir. Okay. Sir, just give me 2 minutes. I have a bar done in my home. I can show you a demo right now, sir. Just, if you have a time, just give me 2 minutes.
Your screen is fixed right now, I think. Purchase order is showing only.
No, I actually opened item master, sir. Is it
No, only
enough,
purchase order is coming.
sir? I came to
It's
home screen.
connecting. It's connecting again.
Sorry, sir. Sir, you please reconnect them. Is it visible now?
Yes, visible.
Sir, so the barcoding can be done, sir. See, the option is here, sir. You can put the all the barcode when you actually are generating something or purchasing an item, sir. Okay,
Barcode
so
is a number I have to give, unique number.
yeah, that unique number, sir. But that barcode sticker, that generation, that is not here, sir. For that part, you have to actually use some separate API or like a third-party solution, which can be easily integrated, sir, here.
Now
Okay, and
barcode to I can generate, but I'm not getting QR code and barcode myself also can generate, but I'm not getting how it will be, why it is required to be linked with SAP. Means if I'm having item number, so what I can do, I can copy this item
okay,
number and I
sir.
can create the barcode of this item number actually.
Exactly, sir. That can be done. But I mean, this is something. Suppose you procured a Fortech keyboard. Okay. So that keyboard is actually having his own barcode, its own barcode.
अच्छा
That barcode, that you can store, even your own part you can
अच्छा
actually
ना ना
store,
भाई,
sir.
but there is one issue ना. Suppose I am purchasing a PC or laptop, it is having a
Yeah.
barcode, but right now at the moment I don't know which laptop I will be going to buy when I am creating the purchase request, because I need the item master, item code. अच्छा, okay, so it will be unique for all laptop.
Yes.
Because suppose I created item code for laptop, है ना?
Yes.
That barcode will represent only laptop, because I will purchase 100 of laptop. So barcode is unique ना, single item.
Yes.
You are getting my point?
Understood. So
Because
in that case,
all
sir.
laptop are having their own barcode, which represent their internal configuration or serial number ना. But
Right,
my
right.
barcode is will represent only this is laptop or this is PC or this is keyboard.
Oh, fine. Then, sir, you don't need. Yes, sir. That much only. Yes, because if you want to store all the item, I mean, you are purchasing 50 laptops, sir. Okay.
Yes.
If you want to go by the system, then you have to create 50 item code.
So all my 50 laptop will having same barcode, na?
Well, yeah. I mean, you can use the same code, or sir, you can use the individual barcode
No,
also there, sir. I mean.
how individual I can use? Because my item code is single na for all laptop. My item code is
Okay.
X for 50 laptops. All are
Exactly,
all
sir.
will be called
Understood.
X.
Okay, sir. Sure, sir. Then let me just show you one demo, sir. I am creating one demo item, sir, here. Okay. Now, what I am going to do, I am generating 990001, which
Sorry,
is
your screen has gone again.
strange. Is it visible now, sir?
Only your welcome screen is coming.
But
I'm
I am
coming.
now in. Because I disconnected you, sir. I already disconnected you. Just please reconnect. Okay, is it better now, sir? Okay, here you can see this item number. I am generating this HP Lenovo. Sorry, not Lenovo. My bad. HP ProBook 661P. Okay, and now it has to be managed by this serial number, sir. This has to be done here. Serial number on every transaction. Okay. Now this item will be serial managed item, and for this ProBook it will have a centralized barcode, only one barcode here. Okay, so now I am doing this HP ProBook as a single one, and I am making this add. Okay, so now my item is created. Now what I'll be doing, sir, I am directly receiving some item only for my good receive, just to avoid that other entries here. Okay, so I'm going 99.
Achha,
now
I
here
have one more thing, my query. What about my purchase request? Same item number,
na? Yeah, of course, sir.
Follow my PR process, PO process, and GRPO process also.
Is it, sir? You can, this PR will not get hampered by anything, sir. I mean, I'm just asking as a future expansion, sir, whichever it is. So, you can just click 99. Okay, so you are requesting maybe 7 laptops. This is the 7 laptops. So, this one item will be only added, sir. Because when I'm requesting, I have no implication of the serial number or any sort of thing, sir.
So
I just need.
No,
that will be never, but sir, it will always restrict you when you are going to receive an item or issue an item. For example, sir, you can check what I did when I generated this item. I selected on every transaction, which means whenever you are doing a good receive, good issue, GRPO, or even stock transfer, every time you have to provide this transaction. Because, for example, sir, in the GRPO warehouse, you have received 7 laptop, serial number is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. But when you, transferred this laptop to the issue warehouse, what you did, you issued actually number 1, number 6, and 7, these 3 laptops. So the quantity is 3, but the serial number you selected as per your requirements, sir. Okay. So now I'm going to here, good received. And it will be like 99. I am putting this quantity as 5. Unit price maybe 75,000 BDT. My project. This move. Okay, this much done. Now I am clicking add. See, this part will be generated here, sir. You can see. Okay, like, because this is a serial managed item. Now my item will restrict me to generate this manufacturer number and all sort of things, sir. Okay, now what you can do, you can also automatic creation and import from Excel. You can even import from Excel also, sir, for your easy access. Okay, and like the automatic generation, what it will be, quantity will be 5. So my serial number, it will be BIF PCL hyphen, it will be like 01. Or what you can do, you can just make this there. So it will be BIFPCL string, and after that there will be a number incremental, and it will be increased from 01. Okay, so this is the, and if you have any lot, like if you want to maintain that lot number, you can put the lot number, suppose BIFPCL hyphen 08. So, as for example, the manufacturing, like as per the manufacturer, it will be 240120. Expiry is, sir, for your warranty purpose or your manufacturing warranty. Here, sir, you can check. Okay.
Just a second, I'm connecting again.
No, sir, no request yet. Sir, can you please check whether the Google Meet is not visible? I mean, I again share my Google Meet screen here, like the entire screen.
Yeah, but only your photo is coming. I don't know why it is coming. Only your picture is presentation. Saif Ahmed Rizvi is written there. Your Mozilla Firefox is not shared.
But I actually shared my entire screen, sir, not only
now,
Mozilla.
Try to share only Firefox screen if possible.
Okay, fine, sir. I'm doing that.
Now only some logo is coming. Firefox logo.
Strange. Okay, sir. I'm trying again, sir. For the last time. Sir, is my desktop is visible now? My desktop is visible, sir.
No, not visible. Stop transfer. I'm again trying any desk. I will share. Let's see. Your imprint is not coming.
Strange. But sir, okay, sir, could you please recheck the AnyDesk again? I just restarted.
What is your ID?
643-523-915. Is it visible?
No.
Oh, fine. So, okay, sir. As you can see, that manufacturing warranty and those sort of things, I'm clicking create. And now you can see that that five automated number has been created already, sir, here. Okay.
So
and now.
Is now created. So,
yes, sir.
I will receive the all items, so I do this barcode.
Exactly, sir. But once, but the problem, this, I mean, you can call it barcode or even, sir, like this manufacturer. Sir, let me show you one thing here. Just give me one moment. Please. That part is not, sir. Basically, this column here, sir, this manufacturing serial number, this is actually the barcode. So if you have a bar gun and you just copy, I mean. Exactly, sir. That will be automatically here. Okay. So now,
from my PC, if gun is connected, then how item barcode will be coming here?
Sir, I mean, whenever you will be trigger the bar gun, it will automatically fetch the information.
No, some plugin automatically will come without SFP.
No, sir. It will be a plug and play mechanism. Sir, it will be plug and play, sir. Just give me 1 second. I am trying to show you, sir, if possible. Just give me 1 minute, please. Yes, sir, it is plug and play. Yes, yes, that's right, sir. I mean, that will reduce your manual entry process that much only. So that can be done. So now I am just clicking update. Okay. And now once I add it. Okay. So now you can see my. And now you can also check, sir, here serial number transaction report. This is additional reports are built in. You can check these five laptop. All these are in direction, in the green direction, sir, because you just received it. Okay. Now, what I'll be doing, sir, I'll be making a stock transfer request. Okay.
Two person wants this laptop, so only two things should be coming here. Warehouse transfer, another warehouse.
Yes, sir. That must need to be checked. Who is actually, asking for this part, but that I also need to check, sir, how can be mapped easily, sir.
One by one, I will go go for a stock transfer request. I will not go in one go.
Okay, okay,
so
fine.
So that my individual name should be recorded. So
fine, sir. So
I will ask for only one laptop.
Okay, great. Then in the
issuing warehouse.
Okay, fine, sir. So let me check in which warehouse I actually saved it. It
can
is in
any other warehouse you are having, take it now. HR store you can take. HR store.
Okay.
Is
there. Okay.
W-06.
Fine. So like from warehouse I'm selecting this HR store. And sorry,
no, no, no.
From
HR it, to where it will go.
Right, sorry, I my mistake, sir. On this side. Okay, so I am just.
My name should be captured somewhere. So Vinod Kundia is asking for this one laptop. So where?
Yeah, sir. That part I think ask for in the remark. So let me just checking. I'm just checking with the built-in form only, sir, so that I can actually check how many additional field will be required or something. Okay, stock transfer request Vinod Kundia. So this will be stored in a journal entry, sir. Okay, I mean the finance team can check from this one. This person is not required. There's a sheet to be
business partner name. What is this? Stock transfer request.
So I'm checking.
This is showing agency name actually.
Yes. BP employee cannot be reimbursed. It cannot be. Okay.
Contact person I can use. This name field I can use.
No, sir. This is actually contact person is that business partner contact. All these people are actually connected. You can ignore this left column, everything, sir. As you can see, the police database, we also made it hidden. That was not required.
In this custom field, it is available anywhere. Open the setting tab, field settings.
Oh, and that's no, sir. That is also not available because, I mean, it is like the, I mean, we need to create user defined field for that. Okay. So that is I'm checking also, sir. I mean, serial number, warehouse, info, price. No, sir. There it cannot be done. But what we can do, we can define some user defined fields, sir. Like as we did in the purchase order. In purchase request, so that much can be done, sir. So I mean, that
so
is.
You got my point. So right now we are putting it in remark, no problem, na? So
okay, okay.
It is going for Vinod now. Stock transfer is being done.
I'm transferring. Okay, I'm actually transferring it. So sir, see, when you are making a request, it did not ask for any serial number or anything, sir.
Okay.
So now what? Now I am a person from the stock
yes.
Or store. Okay, so I'm going to store here. I'm clicking copy from, and I can. What happened?
Receive in the HR store, not this thing.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. But this copy from will not work actually because I need to go to request here. I have to go here. I can check this copy to stock transfer. Okay, so now your request is already visible here, sir. Okay. Okay, so now from the store I am going to add this, but system will give me a pop-up because I am working from which laptop I want to give you, sir. Actually this is 1-2-0. So okay, for example, you can select auto select, or I'm providing this one. Okay, update, it has not been issued yet, sir. Okay, only the location has been changed. Yes, so let me show you
one.
Exactly, sir. You can share here also, sir. See, now this is the stock serial report. In out. It was in where? For in the IM number this much and out. So if you click this document here in the outer document, you can say, okay, in the remarks, Vinod. Based on stock, it is mentioned here, sir. Okay, fine. Now what I need to do, I need to issue this item in against your name, sir. Okay. Now I'm going to good issue from good issue in the sir. Would you please tell me your ID?
My ID EN009383.
Okay, and I'm gonna Vinod Kotia. Okay, your name. And now I'm going to mark this item laptop. Okay, the tricky part is I have to select the warehouse here. Okay, so I need to issue this item from HR warehouse, this 6 here. I selected this warehouse. It is here, my distribution.
This will be job of my store person, actually. He can do it, no problem.
Yeah, yeah. But sir, I mean, I'm thinking, I mean, he or she has to select this warehouse, sir. Okay. And now if I click, okay, let me check whether it, okay. But you can see only one laptop is there and this can automatically pop up. So I need to select this one and I'm sharing this. Now I'm, now it will be issued, sir. Okay. From the stock. And now I'm at, let me check whether it, okay. Document row level project code. Oh, sorry, I think I missed that part again. Okay, I can select it from here also. Okay, sir, now you can see the good has been issued. And if you go to this serial number, okay, this is just one code here. And now what I'll be doing, I'm copying the serial number, sir. Okay, copy. And I'm generating another report, like stock report. Yes, sir, that is done. That is done, sir. And now I'm showing you this report. So serial number transaction report, I am showing you this. Okay, this is not the item number. It has to be 99. Okay, and my posting. So this is another report, sir, actually. Like currently, I am showing you the serial number wise transaction report. Yes, so you can see this HP Proofbook, the item code is same, sir, in this part, as you can see. What I am doing, I have taken this particular serial number, BAPCL02, this laptop. So this laptop, initially, what has been done, it was stocked in as on warehouse number 5 against this GL code, which is in. Later on, what I did, sir, I did it on stock transfer, which is out. Again, what I did, sir, another in transaction happened in that WO6, sir. Here you can see. Okay. Like from warehouse 5, it got out. Warehouse 6 is got in. And later on, sir, this stock out report, it got from warehouse 6. Okay. So this much is done here. And now if you go to the stock transfer posting report, I'm selecting this 9999. And in the expand part, I'm selecting reference number. Sir, your part was
EN0093
and okay, sir, fine. Okay, so sir, here you can see this is now showing the stock transfer for all the HP Proofbook. Okay. Yeah, yeah, that is I'm going, sir. Now here is the reference to, and the remarks is also here, sir. The remarks. Okay. So now you can check the remarks. Okay. There is your name, sir. Vinod Kotia, like as we mentioned, and this is the reference. And now you can check, sir, here. This HP Proofbook, you receive 5 quantity. And after that, one quantity got issued, and another one received in the warehouse 6. As you can see, from 5 you've got issued, it got 1, and now it is. So your current stock is actually 4. Yes, sir. Yeah, yeah, of course, sir. I mean, I'm just showing you whatever the standard offering is here, sir. I mean, this much you can easily receive from here, sir. There's no issue. And this is, sir, one report, and I have also shown you the serial number wise report. And last report you can check. Just 1 minute, sir. I think there is a stock audit report.
Stock return is also
there. Huh, that is also there, sir. I mean, this audit
to be returned back, that can also be recorded.
Huh, that can be also recorded, sir. I mean, the same thing, sir. And this audit report is basically, sir, serve you the purpose with the costing, sir. Okay. For example, in warehouse, you purchase 5 laptop at 75,000 taka. The total value was this much. Then you issue one. So this much has been reduced, and this is the stock value, sir, as of that time. Okay. And later on, what happened, sir? You went to this warehouse 6, and this is the status, sir. Like 75,000 taka received, then 75,000 issued, so the stock value is zero. Because in the HR warehouse, there is no quantity. Okay, sir. Even, sir, if you go to the item master, I mean, these are all the reporting criteria you can check. In the item master, you can see only 4 quantities is there, sir. Because 5 laptop was there, 1 issued. So in the site office, there are 4. And in the HR, there is nothing, sir. You can see it's zero. It's blank. Okay, so... No, that is already there, sir. As you can see here, in this warehouse, sir, which is warehouse 6, this is like warehouse report, sir, audit report. Currently, in this warehouse 6, there is no value. It is zero because this much has been done. Now, if I'm going to this, from the account perspective, sir, I'm going to this HP and I am now going to... No, that will never be removed, sir. I'm showing you, sir. I just give me one moment. I'm going to this GL code. Here you can see this. This is the total value. This is the latest value. In the latest value, sir, it is showing only 330 lakhs because this 75,000 has already been issued, sir. Okay, this is okay. So this much changes, and like, I mean, once the good is issued to someone, so it will be, I mean, provided accordingly, which is out of the stock in that manner, sir. Okay.
So this last report which you showed, no, that is showing everything. My request part, it is also showing, and issue part, it is also showing.
Yes. That is like the stock. This is stock posting report list, sir, which with the remarks and remarks column, sir. Yes. So that was using warehouse because it was by default the stock transfer request, sir. These two transaction, and this is actually your issue transaction, good issue.
This report I can use. This will solve my purpose. Everything is online actually. Request is done online, and
yes, yeah. Exactly. But sir, I would also suggest you, sir, to cross check with the finance team, sir, like from their perspective also, like showing this record and other things, so they can also, you know, provide their feedback whether, you know, any kind of changes is required or not, sir. That much only. Yes. Right.
Laptop, then I have to do all this exercise up front. But this issue should not come. That serial number thing, that should not be a hurdle for me creating PR, PO, and GRPO. Only these three things.
No, but sir, I mean, in the GRPO, there will be the serial number issue will be there.
Okay, GRPO, so, that time I will get. GRPO, I will make only when I have received my item. I have received
exactly,
my
yes.
Laptop and I know the serial number. That time I can do the entry. But during the
process, sir, sir, currently this serial number is not activated, sir. I mean, this is an option which you can actually implement in your business, sir, which I am suggesting. So you also have a, I mean, discussion with your team, sir, so that, I mean, if there... Sure, sir. Sure, sir. Sir, but I mean, at least, I mean, before starting, you should take at least 1 month as your, you know, preparation and other things.
So that we can do proper trial for this thing.
Exactly.
That
Because sir, I mean, one confession, my answer, because I mean, as we are in the support phase with you, sir, I am not sure whether this would be a, scope enhancement or like the support thing, sir. So that clarity I also need to get from my management, sir, just to be moving properly, sir. That's what I am asking. So. Sure, sure, sir. That. No, no, that is okay. Actually, sir, see, I mean, whatever your requirement is in the SAP dimension, sir, I can definitely cater you with all kind of clarity, sir. That I'm pretty much confident, sir. No issue. Okay, even, sir, I mean, going forward, your service you can also include here, sir, like this warranty and other issues, sir. That can be a pretty good expansion for your business requirements, sir. Okay, so that much on clarity. But okay, another thing, sir, regarding this stock part. This laptop and other issue, whether you will mark it as an asset or not. So
that will be asset. Some bigger items will be asset. Like my laptop will be asset.
Okay, okay. So in that case, sir, I mean, there will be a.
In that case, now what is going to happen? All my asset is having unique item code. Actually, if I go for 50 laptop, I will have 50 item code for each laptop.
Exactly, sir. Yes. So and also, sir, you have to make a proper fixed asset entry here as an asset master, because whenever you are declaring something as an asset, you have to put the depreciation and other policy for this.
But this asset master data, when I will create, because my process is like that. Suppose I want to buy 5 laptop, na? Then what I will do? I will create 5 unique item code first.
Yes. Yes. Understood.
Do purchase order, then I will do GRPO. Then when this asset master data will come into picture,
sir, at the very beginning when you selling that 5 item master code.
No, but item I have not purchased it, so how it will reflect in the asset master,
sir? It will come into the
I don't know the price also. When I purchase,
well, I mean,
item master, that time
you will be only understood, sir. You will be only creating those code, that much only, sir, like 5 code. Like whatever your item is, you can see, sir, here, I mean, in the fixed asset part. Okay, here you can see that in this top, just 1 minute, sir. Okay, there is the serial number and stock number, sir. So at the very beginning, when you have not purchased or anything, you are just generating this code, this much only, this header data. Like there will be 5 codes, sir, because once you purchased a fixed asset, either you can capitalize it from this window or from the GRPO, it can be done. Because in the even in the stock item master, sir, here, let me show you. This is also have a mechanism with that fixed asset code. Just 1 minute, sir, I'm showing you. Yes, yes. So that can be also, so sir, this decision, it actually can be taken from the finance team, sir, like how they actually want to map it. Because to make the process easier, we prepared one fixed asset group here, sir, like which will serve your purpose, I mean, fully, and it will also give you the report. So this is like a workaround for the minimal item, which is asset, but you do not want to make it a complicated entry in the asset master data. That is why only, sir. Okay, so I mean, whatever your fixed asset purpose is, that can be easily served through that fixed asset group also. But here, if you want to,
fixed asset will come into picture only after my PO or GRPO has been created. Actually, before that,
exactly, sir.
Yeah. It is not relevant actually, because why don't?
No, that it is not.
File laptop will be. Haha,
it is.
Those 5 laptops, but I don't know.
Yes, sir, but you can see
reflected into the asset or not.
Asset, sir, that can be actually mapped as per your requirement also. For example, sir,
will
you have created
after GRPO, it should be reflected in the asset.
Yeah, that can be done, sir, because this capitalization date, sir, it is actually the GRPO. I mean, which day you are actually capitalizing? That can be done, sir. And here you can see, I mean, your number will be your stock number, sir, rather than your item code or anything. So whenever you have the stock number, this can be done, sir. So it is pretty much possible, sir. I mean, all the provision is already there, sir. Like how you want to market in which way. So that is, sir, already there, which you can easily actually map, I mean, back and forth, both way.
Single single row, this vehicle or chair, we purchase
Understood, yes, sir.
500 share, the 500 assets is there.
Sir, actually, there is another mechanism for this asset creation. Like, if the asset is serial managed, you can make it as a virtual item. I mean, this is the standard offer. Yes, exactly, sir. The similar kind of thing, but then it treat as a virtual item. It can also be, sir, adjusted. I mean, if you just select this asset group in here, then you just tick mark this and it will already there. For that, you have to provide the item number series, because with the manual series, the system cannot generate a virtual item. So whenever you are generating item number series, you just tick mark this one and it will automatically provide you that part also, no issue. And you can also check, sir, I mean, if you go to this help, contextual help, oh, I think my window is not here. You can just check this virtual item in YouTube also, sir. You will have a very clear idea from that part. I mean, already is there in a very better way, sir. That is why I am not describing it right now. Okay, sir, as you are having time, let me also provide you a clarity in that AWS portal issue, sir, which you asked that I am user, sir.